turn two.
Thank you.
charging, second place finish. Came close to being the first ever repeat winner of this race. Just tell us about your run.
Oh, it was good. The racetrack's a little slick. It had a nice cushion up there for a while. You know how Brady and them guys run that real wide down off the straightaways, and just make the racetrack real big. But the cushion was decent up there. I know down at this end was fast all night. I never went up there and tried it really all night. I just had a good race car around the bottom, and first time in this car, so just kind of learning some things, and got a decent finish out of it. Got to thank my crew, Jared and Tony Fox, for giving me the opportunity, and didn't end up too bad.
Hi, race fans. Your second place finisher, Dave Darlanda, here at Brownstown. We'll come over here and talk to Brady Short. But it looks like the bottom just worked better for Chris, and you just stayed married to the top side.
Yeah, obviously, if you've seen me race here before, I'm always around the top side. A couple years back, we won a USAC race doing that, and it started to work there. And then I seen him come back around on the bottom, and there the last 10 laps to go, I just drove the hell out of it, trying to run around the top, and went over a little bit off of four and kind of cost me a spot there. But the tractors kind of come in a little bit better on the bottom, so hats off to them guys. I can't do that around here. I just get too tight, so we'll take third and move on.
All right, Brady, congratulations. Let you guys. We're going to top three picture here in just a few. Brady Short, tonight's third place finisher. All right, we'll step in and get a word with our winner. Christopher Bell, you're one for one in non-wing sprint car racing. How does it feel?
Man, it feels amazing. I'm just so blessed to be able to drive the Keith Coons Motorsports number 67. I mean, it's just all about your car, especially here at this slick place, and they gave me an awesome race car. All I had to do was just sit in there and drive it.
To win this race, the No Out 40, the Jesse Hockett Memorial Race, 7,500 to win. Obviously, this has to mean a lot to you. Where would you rank this as far as your wins in your career?
It's way up there for sure. I looked up to Jesse a lot, and it's a shame he's gone, man. I would love to got to race with him.
Now, tell us about your background. First race in a non-wing sprint car. You raced the wing sprints, the midgets. What got you guys together for this race?
Keith and Pete got a hold of me about mid-December and asked me if I'd like to run the Chili Bowl for them, and then we went to the Chili Bowl and kind of decided to try out this year and see how it went.
How'd you guys, obviously you guys set up for this race. What was your mindset going into this race? Did you guys set up for the bottom?
Yeah, well, we just set up kind of roll through the middle, and then it ended up coming in really good down there. I was pretty surprised because those first couple laps, I was able to roll through the middle really nice.
All right, we'll let you guys go back and celebrate. Your winner of the fifth annual No Way Out 40 out of Norman, Oklahoma, Christopher Bell.